Coming up, big questions about Sophie Monk's future at Channel 9. Plus, who's out to get TV and radio presenter Sophie Formica? It's a big question many in the media are asking today. And the best thing to come out of the US debate must be this song based on a classic line from Trump.
They're eating the dogs. Whoa, 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 whoa. They're eating the cats.
Meow, 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 meow.
They're eating the pets of the people that live there.
Hello, I'm Rob McKnight. Welcome to Inside Media. It's been a tough 6 months for ABC chair Kim Williams. Now, while he hasn't been afraid to lay down the law with staff, he's told them activism is not welcome at the taxpayer-funded broadcaster, he now has some big decisions to make regarding an independent inquiry into its prestigious news division. The ABC has been dragged kicking and screaming into ordering a review into the doctored audio fiasco relating to Heston Russell. And the true independence of that review will be seen as a reflection of Williams' credibility. Williams seems to have taken a more hands-on approach regarding editorial decisions than most of his recent predecessors, who've been kept at arm's length through bureaucratic ABC procedure. That means that even though he inherited this mess, he will be the one who is ultimately judged on how transparent and forthright the review ends up being. Let's recap. 7 News Spotlight revealed 5 extra gunshots had been added to a video which originally only contained one. In the story, independent forensic digital audio expert James Raper explained his findings against the ABC video.
So we can hear that there's one distinct gunshot in that footage. Now,
the warning shot.
The warning shot.
Heston talks about.
That's correct. Yeah. That's correct. That one gunshot lines up perfectly across both the helmet cam footage and the souvenir video. This changes when we get to the news clip. If we listen to it, we'll be able to hear 6 distinct gunshots.
This is like the magic pudding.
Mm.
So we've added another 5 gunshots.
That's what the evidence points to.
Since that revelation, the ABC has been in damage control, at first attacking the producers of Spotlight with a blistering statement saying, "Given the information that has emerged this year about Spotlight's conduct and approach to journalism, we have no confidence in engaging with your program." Later, when presented with the evidence, the ABC removed the video from its website and YouTube page. Another statement issued to Spotlight read, "We have removed the online video where an error has been identified, based on preliminary inspection of the audio." The ABC is seeking more information on how this occurred. It was classic ABC. Attack first, deny any wrongdoing, assume everyone's out to get you, until, of course, the evidence mounts up. But it gets worse. It's emerged the ABC was informed about the doctored audio almost 2 years ago. On Friday, outgoing managing director David Anderson issued a statement saying, "It has now come to my attention that in November 2022, ABC Legal was sent a letter raising concerns about the audio editing. Regrettably, at no point was this letter or the information in the letter disseminated to ABC News. He's now ordered an independent review." Well, about time. But guess what? There's still been no actual apology. And despite all the evidence, the ABC is still being defensive about the reporting of the story. The Australian Report's news boss Justin Stevens took issue with the use of the word doctored to describe the audio error, saying, and I quote, "You use the word doctor, which is an extremely high allegation to make of any journalist, that a journalist would falsify information for their own journalistic gain." What else do you call it? A piece of video with one gunshot was edited to make it sound like 6 shots were fired. That's not doctored. I really don't know what is. Inside Media has put the following questions to the ABC. We did this first thing this morning. 1, who will be running the review? 2, how long is the review expected to take? 3, will all of the findings of the review be made public? 4, as the ABC has acknowledged the error, why isn't an apology forthcoming? Now, look, I asked for answers to be provided by midday in order to allow the recording of this video. Late on Monday afternoon, the ABC has not replied. If they do, I'll update the Inside Media column on the 7 News website. A few months ago, I revealed Channel 9 had picked up a big new format called The Floor. It's a game show with 81 contestants who all have a square. The aim is to beat the other players and take their squares. It's actually a pretty good show. The host in the US is none other than actor Rob Lowe, and according to the Daily Mail, the new Australian host is set to be the likeable Sophie Monk. Well, that's at odds with my mail that says Roger Corser has been overseas filming the show with Aussie expats. Nine are trying to save the big announcement for their annual upfront event in October. That's the annual showcase to media and advertisers where the network will reveal its big plans for 2025. Even if Sophie isn't the host of the floor, it certainly seems like she's ready to move on from Love Island. According to the Daily Mail article, Nine had approached former Big Brother contestant Skye Wheatley as a potential replacement for Monk. Things took a dramatic turn, though, when Wheatley underwent dramatic plastic surgery recently, with a source telling the outlet, "I don't think Nine was unconfident with her ability to host the show. I think it was just the look they were hiring her for that has changed." Now, look, that might have set off a chain reaction forcing Monk to remain with Love Island. We'll find out that and more when Nine makes some big announcements next month. But I'm pretty confident Roger Corser will be hosting the floor. Someone has it in for 4BC radio host Sophie Formica, if leaks to media are any indication. For the past few months, there has been a steady stream of misinformation being reported based on biased sources. But who is it and what is their motive? This line in the Courier Mail yesterday has raised plenty of eyebrows. It says, the seasoned radio presenter was notably absent from an internal email sent to staff on Thursday, which outlined the station's programming shakeup, including Gary Hardgrave's continuation in the drive slot, filling the position vacated by Peter Gleeson. Okay, let's cut through the spin. Inside media can reveal no other presenters were mentioned in the email to staff except for Peter Fegan and Gary Hardgrave. Why? That's because the email was all about their new positions. There wasn't any mention of Bill McDonald or any of the other regular presenters on 4BC, but the source of this article failed to mention that to the reporter. There are plenty of other examples, but suffice to say, there's a lot of finger-pointing going on at the moment over who's leaking what. And from what I'm told, the bosses at Nine Radio, they love Sophie. And look, full disclosure, I was Sophie's executive producer for a couple of years at 4BC, and I still present an entertainment report twice a week. And speaking of Peter Fegan, the Channel 9 journalist has won the coveted breakfast gig replacing outgoing trio Laurel, Gary and Mark. Fegan will host the show for the remainder of the year. That basically means executives think he is the future, but they're hedging their bets by seeing what the last 10 weeks of ratings bring. If he rates, he'll stay. If he maintains current figures, he'll probably stay. If ratings go down, that's when there'll be a rethink. One of the funniest quotes to come out of the US presidential debate between Kamala Harris and Donald Trump would have to be this one.
In Springfield, they're eating the dogs, the people that came in. They're eating the cats. They're eating the pets of the people that live there.
Well, now that phrase has been turned into a hit song by South African musician David Scott. Since being uploaded 9 days ago, the YouTube video has been viewed almost 8 million times and is shooting up the charts of other streaming services like Spotify.
They're eating the dogs. They're eating the cats. They're eating the pets of the people that live there.
People of Springfield, please don't eat my cats. Why would you do that? Eat something else. People of Springfield, please don't eat my dog. Here's a catalog of other things to eat.
They're eating the dogs.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
They're eating the cats.
Meow, 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 meow.
They're eating the pets of the people that live there. They're eating the dogs.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
They're eating the cats.
Meow, 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 meow.
They're eating the pets of the people that live there.
I love it. I love it. And that's it for this edition of Inside Media. I'll be back on Thursday with more rants and more insights at 7news.com.au. I'm Rob McKnight. I'll see you then.
They're eating the cats.